Whoa, whoa. Yeah. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Cross move quick like AI. Chain shine bright like daytime. Stack big bread like waist high. I don't do lanes. Lil' watch y'all like 2 Chainz. I done swerved in a new lane. Dang, get the grit, do things. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah, no it ain't, no it. They ain't talking cash, so I did the race. NASCAR with the pace, Fiji water on the chain. You know love where I'm from. When I'm on a beat, I make it thump. I need that bread like every crumb. Came up from nothing, made a sum. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Ay, 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 ay.
I sound
okay, I'm back to school, you. This is open campus. This is I should slap it open-handed. Tough life, I told a model she need lower standards. Asked her if she had a twin, I feel like Joey Tanner. Big spender, Kris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, what's happening? Think she called me, cause she never knew her daddy. And my all black, Rhythm Nation, Janet, boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, was underground. Was underground. Frontin' like a ride with the mob. Why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I?
All right, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the New England Patriots. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. On the stop was Aaron Donald.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Yeah. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. On the give, this is their fullback. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
And that's a nice gain by him on first down, picking up some key yardage.
Fullback on the dive, and he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. Darren Lee there to get him down.
And that was a good collision right there, and I know this as a former defender. If you're playing linebacker, you're going through a checklist on every play, who you think's going to get the ball, where you think the ball's going to go. Rarely do you expect the fullback position to get it, and on that play he did. So you've got to steel yourself at that point because the contact is going to be strong.
Well, that's a tough, costly penalty because now it makes it 3rd and 6 after the false start.
2 for 76.
A shotgun snap for Gong. Forced out to his left. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got him. Still fighting. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. They convert on 3rd with a gain of 22. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go 3 and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover. Gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to it. Hey, you guys got the turnover. We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
Here's Goff now on 2nd down. Flushed out right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked off inside the 5. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They'll start things on 1st with Torrey Cohen. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bud Dupree. And the field position doesn't get much better than this. They'll have it 1st and goal at the 8-yard line. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. Jared Goff, his 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Panthers have tied this game up. They can take the lead with the extra point. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now. Here's Gone. Escaping the pressure right. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. As his guys are in for 6. And the Panthers are going to take a 1st quarter lead. Oh, such great concentration. They're going right up against the side of the end zone, but able to get the feet in bounds.
There are so many things that go into that catch. And you just mentioned the concentration, being able to catch the football, get your feet down in bounds, hang on to it all the way through the process of the catch. That was a phenomenal play.
This will be taken in at the 1. And an alley to run. And what a return. Great field position all the way out to the 48-yard line.
Well, you gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big-time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
Very good starting position for the Patriot offense as they come up first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to air one. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Buda Baker with a pick. And he will bring this all the way back out to midfield.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
Super 66. 17.
After the interception, here's Gall. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Well, now a carry here for the fullback. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Well, he tried to bounce it outside, but that's obviously not his game. He's too much of a straight-line runner.
Yeah, him in the outer third of the field, not a recipe for success. That time, a loss. Throwing on third. Gone. Steps away to his left. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be fourth down. Here we go on fourth. Goff. He's going to rifle one deep left side. This is caught at the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going. It's Kalen Ballage, and they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. They run it with Ballage. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Here we go, fellas. Here we go. Here we go.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Panthers in possession. Fullback try and push the pile. Able to fight through one tackle. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. 2 of their 3 red zone trips so far they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
So second and goal, and standing by himself in the backfield, Barkley. 76. They'll give it to him up the middle, and he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Saquon Barkley with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And it's 15-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to get this deep on the Carolina side of the field. It's a big play there for the Patriots. 58 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
All right, here we go. Green 39, green 39.
Back to throw now on second and 10. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. Yeah, he's got it. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. In for the score. And the Patriots are back within a score.
As the offense went on the field to start their last drive, you know they discussed it in the huddle. Hey, if we put one in the end zone here, we put ourselves in a position to start making a comeback.
PAT up and good by Rosas. And that'll make our score 14-7. This is fielded at the goal line. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They're starting to pull away with this one early on that first quarter. They didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you gotta like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But fortunately, a Panther was able to get on this. So Carolina keeps the ball.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. There they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
The Panthers on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and forever. From the gun, here's Goff. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Kayvon Webster on the defensive side able to get a hand in.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
On now, Kayser, the punter, sending it away. This is taken at the 15. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And the Patriots take over. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division. Looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals. All right, number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for everyone possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round.
Here we go now.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Caught on the right side, Reed. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Looking to throw. Buying time to his left. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, and his first carry of the game right there, he had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Reed. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
They'll set up to throw. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the flags, and I believe this is going to be a first down. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10.
Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Set. Green 39. Green 39.
He'll look to throw. He'll get this over to Westbrook. It's complete. And he gets it down to the 32. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Now back to throw. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. That one goes for 24 yards.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. This is Cohen on the toss. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. A great effort there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. Rosas good with the extra point. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. He's going to let this go deep. And got his man complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Goff on first down. He'll get this out to Barkley complete. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Goff now 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Out of the gun, Goff, eluding the pressure right, and avoids the contact by sliding. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Left, left, left.
To throw on second down is Goff. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Now it's gone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. As his guys are in for 6, and the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They'll throw now on the final play. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we come upon halftime intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman ready with our EA Sports halftime report. Coach Rosas now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
They'll try and run with their fullback. And not much doing. He'll get this only up to about the 36. Kayvon Webster there to make the tackle.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defensive coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
On second down, here's Goff, being chased out left. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. The Panthers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Goff now to throw. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Hey, go down. Start left here. Super 66. Go 12, go. Go 12, go. Go 12, go.
They are going for it. Gone. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They'll run it here. This is their fullback getting the carry and trying to push forward, but he is going to be stuffed up in the backfield. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Back to their fullback, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. He'll wind up getting 11 on that one, and that'll bring up a third and one.
Watching that run takes me back to something a famous old coach once said. Any player he wants on his team, he wants him to be agile, mobile, and most definitely hostile.
The Panthers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. They're up against a third and one situation. Goff now looks to throw. Got an open man. It's Ratley. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. The 13 yards that time of the first. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Well, they've gone to their fullback quite a bit. He'll get it again. Unable to corral him. He fights through. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Now a first down throw. Gone. They still can't get him. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. A shotgun snap for Gone. Dancing to his left. And this one is incomplete.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfires.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time. He definitely wants that one back.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
and there was absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. Third down, and he has all the time in the world to eventually find an open receiver for a first down pickup.
Now gone. And he fires one incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me that option of running play action, maybe throwing it.
The line of scrimmage, once again, the five as they get ready for second and goal. To the air again. Gone. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
The Panthers on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. 14. They're looking at a third and goal here. Again, golf. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
So typically you'd say nice job defensively to force a decision on fourth down, but they've already gone for it once and converted, so you better make sure your defense stays out on the field and is alert.
And his kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. Well, that will go down as a 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment?
It's funny. We had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator. And what did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? An extra point, a punt, or a field goal. Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down.
Lucky 56.
Back to throw here. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That, I believe, will put him over 100 yards receiving for the game. Yes, it will. And he's got a first down to boot. To throw now on first down. And he completes it to Westbrook. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. He'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. Incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down.
Blue 90.
They'll set up a throw. The open man is Westbrook, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
No. Check. Patriot.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. He lost two there, and it's third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They'll look to throw here. He'll leave it for Cohen, complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It's a gain of 9 yards, and that'll bring up fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Well, going deep here for Taylor. And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call. So first and 10 after a big mistake on fourth down with a penalty.
All right, here we go. 319! 319!
They're going to look to throw. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Give him six on the play, and it'll be a second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Bud Dupree. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games. And now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
After the interception, here's Goff. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this.
Two for 66.
Goff going to throw it. He sets the fire deep. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times, tried to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful.
He'll rifle this one. He's got a man, complete. 20, 10, for touchdown, Carolina. Damian Ratley, 85 yards. And the Panthers add on to their lead. No problem there on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that.
I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better.
Yeah. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Bud Dupree. And they'll have the ball set up in the red zone at the 16-yard line. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
But someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. He's got it complete, and he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
76.
Throwing now. Goff escaping the pressure right, and he's got the hookup here complete, and here he'll get it down to the 7. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Wants to throw on third and one. Steps away to his left. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss him? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
On fourth down, Goff. Buying time to his left. This will be caught at about the 5. So the decision to go for it turns out to be a good one. They get a couple of yards, and as a result, the drive keeps moving. It's now first and goal. And they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Goff throwing again. Flush to his right. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So second and goal, and standing by himself in the backfield, Barkley. Looks like he'll throw here. And this will be caught. Well, forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Well, I know at points of this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Panthers, they continue to put themselves in position for a first-round bye as they move to 8-2. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Atlanta to take on the Falcons. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, they suffered just their second loss as they drop to 8-2 now on the year. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens. That'll do it for us.
told the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, it's happening. Think she called me, think she, cause she never knew her daddy. And my black Rhythm Nation, Janet, boy, don't make me Jackson. Bodily, what's underground? Frontin' like a ride with the mob. Why shouldn't I charge? Me, myself, and I. Play the odds. A yes, man, it's just a bobblehead doll. Holler them all. Strutting like Pac out the court. Hop out the Porsche. Shake that. Got that. On menu, the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. Sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my. Age. We was gangin' since the platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being Hova, action movie, yay. Listen, babe, listen, so good you think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing, I could Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy being truthful, baby. Baby, for real, overload. This is like I got like my pinky, Money, baby, we don't, baby, it ain't ours. Bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style. Chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF chains down. I gave you prophecy, my first one, then you lamed out. Luckily, sold, but it wasn't for me. Still the flow raw, peep the way I bubble in these streets. Who can f*** with me?
Nikki, baby.
Go.
Count, cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now. Yo. I'm too on one day on my third. I was too broke, now I'm too rich. Made 100K on my third shift. I'm a boy, so boy, and I'm a gangster. And you a boy.
Man, we been getting money for a long time. We was out here hungry for a long time. I don't never really had no punchlines. All you rappers looking like a lunch line.
Ooh. Right now, I got you. Right now.
Nothing. Need a Uber. Right now. Right now. Need crew love. Right now. Cause we two up. Right now.
Ooh. I'm up right now. Ooh. I'm up right now.
First I pull up. Hop out. Walk out, all these bands I lost count, cause I'm too up right now.
Too up right now.
Yo, I'm too up. Round blew up. Copped a new rape on them haters. Threw up. Brought them, went to jail for them. Told me you up. First time I seen 100 bands, yeah, I grew up. Ooh, on the couch with my shoe up. And we was getting that record label money before they knew us. And we were blowing your budget in the club to the booth up. If your dog falling, your ball hog and get your whole crew up.
Ooh, I'm with right now, I got you. Right now,
nothing. Need a Uber right now. Right now, need crew love right now. Cause we two up right now.
Ooh, I'm up right now.
Hop out, ballet, walk out, all these bands I lost count, cause I'm too up right now.
Too up right now.
I like when birds come out, sounds like I see it in that. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that,
yeah.
You from the back of the. I got a girl, Brad.
Yeah.
She go to battle. LED loaded the tag.
Yeah.
I go in back of the.
Yeah.
they all from it. My diamonds, they all look it. This, that, I go to bed on bed. I got the beam in the flex. I got a in the back. Haters, they talk to chat. They step on the rock, the man. I'm a K-back. 400K. I found out where you lay at. I got the lurking and they hate cats. Pockets, they fat. I got the from the block and they spamming. They know what banks at. I got the that work on the avenue. They know what tanks at. I got the that live in the mansion. They know what at. I got some that's up in the jail and they know what that. I came on top of the building again. Yeah, my we had a plan. We came on top of the building again. Yeah, my we never ran. Down there, thought that I had a fan. Oh, hey, any. 10 o'clock, got a flight out, yeah, I'm going back out to Japan. I got two Billy truck and a bitch door with a land. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Batman, I'm best man. I got my best man. I got my... I go to hotels when I step out, yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclubs for the... Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Go hard, can't face, man. Choppers, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life and you give it a wasteland. This what happens when you give it a fake life and then... Yeah. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the. I got a girl, Brett. Yeah. She go to battle. She, yeah. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the. I got a girl, Brett. Yeah. She go to battle.